So this is to show you the position of the appendix and variable position of the appendix. And this cadaver, just to make you oriented, this is the greater omentum here. I will reflect the greater omentum. And this is the small intestine. Here is the cecum and the ascending colon and the transverse colon. Now, the cecum here, I will remove part of the small intestine. I can move it because it has mesentery. You can see the cecum here. This is the terminal ileum, where it ends into the cecum here. And you can see the appendix, which is hanging from the cecum, going into the pelvis. So this is the appendix here. This is the appendix. You can see the mesentery of the appendix, the mesoappendix. And the appendix is a pelvic appendix. This kind of appendix, when it gets inflamed, it can be palpated as a tender area in rectal examination. The pelvic appendix is the second commonest position of the appendix. About 30% of the position of the appendix is a pelvic appendix. This is another cadaver showing another position of appendix. In this cadaver, I want you to get oriented to start with. Again, this is the greater omentum here, and they will reflect it. This is the transverse colon and transverse mesocolon. This is the ascending colon and the cecum. These are the loops of small intestine. And so this is the terminal ileum ending into the cecum. If I move the cecum, I can find that the appendix is behind the cecum. So this is the appendix here. It has a retrocecal appendix. Again, you can see the mesentery of the appendix, the mesoappendix, but the appendix is retrocecal in position. It is not pelvic in position like what we have seen earlier. And this is the most common position of the appendix, retrocecal appendix. About 65% of people have retrocecal appendix when they are operated on during appendicectomy. I want you to notice the relation of this appendix to the peritoneum behind and to the psoas major muscle. This is the psoas major muscle, which is closely related to the posterior aspect of the appendix. The psoas major is covered by fascia, and this fascia gets irritated in cases of appendicitis, and that's why patients with appendicitis, they develop pain during extension of the hip joint. Because of the stretching of the muscle, psoas major muscle, and its fascia, which are closely related to the retrocecal appendix, as you can see here. This is another cadaver. Again, this is the terminal ileum, and this is the region of the appendix at the cecum. I opened the cecum. You can see here, for example, the tenia coli on the surface of the cecum. This is the tenia coli. And the tenia coli, they join together at the base of the appendix. So this is the position of the base of the appendix. I opened the cecum. You can see the inside of the cecum. You can see the ileocecal orifice. The orifice here is labial in form, and it has two frenulae. It's located on the medial aspect of the cecum. Distal to this orifice is the other orifice, which is the orifice of the appendix, the appendiceal orifice, distal to it on the posteromedial surface. Again, you can see the appendix has mesentery, and this mesentery contains an artery, which is the appendicular artery. The appendicular artery is a branch of the posterior cecal artery. So you can see that there is different positions of the appendix. Sometimes it is pelvic appendix, as we have seen in the first place. Sometimes it is a retrocecal appendix, And sometimes it is like in here, it can be described as a retroileal appendix, which passes behind the ileum. This is the least common location of the appendix, retroileal, constituting probably less than 5% of the appendices. But most common is the retrocecal or the pelvic appendix. So the most common position of the appendix is retrocecal. But whatever the position of the appendix, the tip of the appendix and the appendix itself, the base of the appendix, that's to say the place of the appendiceal orifice where the appendix opens into the cecum, the base of the appendix is fixed. And this point is located on the anterior abdominal wall as located on a line that lies one-third of the way between the anterior superior iliac spine to the umbilicus, right superior iliac spine to the umbilicus, one-third of the way. And this point is called McBurney's point, and it marks the position of the base of the appendix. Whatever the position of the appendix, whether retrocecal, pelvic, or retroileal, this point is fixed.